Davis out there. Ophelia Watt, good morning. Please, as you enter the line, start share the line. We need 50 share this morning. Because we are about to beat the devil bad. Susan Williams, good morning to you. Miss Cameron, good morning. Janet Armstrong, good morning. Evrita Malcolm out there. Let God arise and all the enemies be scattered. We're going to go right up into praise and worship. But before we do so, let us give God thanks for life. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, we come before you this morning. We give you thanks. We give you praise for a brand new day. We thank you for life. We thank you for grace. We thank you for mercy. We thank you for what you have done, what you're about to do. Heavenly Father, Prince of Peace, great Emmanuel God, great Jehovah Jireh, my provider, great Jehovah Nissi, great Jehovah Shalom, author and finisher of my faith. Lord, as we're about to go through this prayer line, this morning, Sunday morning service, Lord, we're giving you thanks for life. We're telling you thanks for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your love. We thank you for waking us up, Lord. We could have been in the land of the dead, but because of your grace and your mercy, you have kept us. We are in the land of the living. Father, I'm asking thee to touch this platform this morning as we're about to go through the line. Father, I'm asking thee, O God, to touch your woman servant this morning. Touch this vessel, O God. Cleanse this vessel. Father, if I've sinned against thee through the past month, week, days, hour, Lord, I ask you for forgiveness, Lord. Clean up this vessel, Lord God. Clean it up from the crown of the head to the sole of my feet. From the sole of my feet to the crown of my head. Make me an instrument of thy peace, Lord, where there is hatred, love, sadness, joy, despair, hope, O God Almighty. I'm asking thee, O God, at this time, to open up your atmosphere this morning. Send forth the new word, O God Almighty. Send forth battalion of angels for protection, O God Almighty. Keep your woman servant focused on the line this morning, O God Almighty. Your word says we are one, two, and three are gathered. You are in the midst. So this morning, O God, as we send up the praises to you, when the praises go up, the blessings come down. When the praises go up, the healing come down. When the praises go up, deliverance come down. Father, I ask of you right now to keep me focused. Touch the line this morning, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, O God Almighty. Touch all the platforms this morning, O God. Remove anything that is not of you, Lord God. Every provoker, remove them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Lord God Almighty. Cut and clear the liver, Lord God Almighty. Loose the atmosphere and set us free. Labraka shata rebeke sata rebeko sataya. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, as it is written, O God, so shall it be. Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. We are looking for 50 share this morning. So as you enter, start sharing the videos. Let us do our declaration for women. Then we get right up into praise and worship. And then the word. Glory, hallelujah. If you are just joining the line for the first time, I must welcome you to the service this morning. If you are new to the line, welcome. You are most welcome. All we ask you for today is good behavior. Remember, as you enter the line, each person share the videos 10 times for your blessings. Glory, hallelujah. And always remember, judge not lest ye be judged. So while you enter this line, do not judge. Do not judge, because none of us is God. Let God be the judge this morning. Judge not lest ye be judged. Declaration for women. I am a woman of excellence. Call your name where I call my name. Divine is a woman of excellence, a virtuous woman, a God-fearing woman, a courageous woman, a blessed woman, a valuable woman. I am designed for a particular purpose. I am loved, protected, and empowered by God. Greatness exists in divine. I am aware that there is life and death is within the power of the tongue. Therefore, I declare that I will endeavor to bless all those who I come in contact with. I will bless and not curse. I am mandated to effect change and make positive impact in this world. I denounce and reject every negative thing spoken over my life and in the life of my loved ones. It will have no effect. I have everything I need to accomplish my purpose. I am whole in my body, mind, soul, and spirit. I am blessed in every area of my life, physically, socially, mentally, financially, relationally, and interpersonally. I speak peace, wealth, prosperity, wisdom, courage, favor, success into my life and in the life of my loved ones. I am special. Divine is valuable. I have a purpose in life. With the preservations of God's help, I will accomplish my purpose. Glory be to the Father, and unto the Son, and unto the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I want all of you to get your books together, because we are going to be into Jerusalem schoolroom today. It is not much of a preaching today. It is much more of teaching today. Glory, hallelujah. I get a specific word for the people that looks like me, the people of black descendant, bronze complexion. Today is the word the Almighty God has sent to all of us. Now is not the time for us to play church, to play with ourselves, because the Almighty God designed us as He designed Himself. And the Lord take us very serious. And I want for you to know, there is a lot of things that the Almighty God wants you to know. And He leads me to the scriptures that back up His argument. So let us get right up into praise and worship before we drop the fire. And before I tell you what the Lord God Almighty said to tell the black race. Glory. Hallelujah. Glory. We're going to deal specifically with the black race this morning. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give the Lord God Almighty some praise. My soul, to your friends. Even if they don't want it on their page, share it on their page. This is something that they must hear. So even if you share it on their page and they delete it, that is their good luck. Get over it, it's so wide, can't get around it. because the argument them strong this morning. These kind of arguments, you have to write them down. You can't just listen to the message and then skip past. I said, get your book, you're gonna be in Jerusalem schoolroom today. These arguments very, very strong. Whether you're a pastor or you're evangelist, get your book. Whether you're worldly or you're a Christian, get your book. Because the Almighty God is speaking. The Almighty God has talked up some things. Mighty God of Daniel. And this is specifically for the black race, but white people, if you're near, draw near, come listen to the truth. Because the Almighty God start reveal himself now. So all of us who were wondering what God looked like and who God really is, gotta talk up now. This morning, as a black woman, me hyping a God this morning. I am so hyping Yahweh this morning because I'm a talk of things them. Rock my soul, Mrs. Karen Sankey. Good morning. How did do, Janet Armstrong? Send us text, talk up, God, talk up. Hey, rock my soul. Me say, God, I talk the things them. You never know, say, God, I talk up the things. Mighty God, I talk up the things that I use scripture for back it. My God, when the black people, them, they run cross. I say, whether you're a pastor or you are evangelist, run in. Whether you're a prophet or you're a Christian, run in. Whether you are worldly and run cross. And if you're white people, come cross, come hear this for yourself. Because the Almighty God talk up and give it back up with it too. You know when you join this kind of line with radical Ronia, so just text talk up, God, talk up. Talk up, my daddy, talk up. Rock my soul. Hey, hey, rock my soul. My God, you see, we are warm up, you know, we are warm up because I got a talk up. Mighty God, rock my soul. Eva Campbell, good morning. Deborah Fennell, good morning. My. I say God talking up, gotta talk up pure things, gotta talk up beer things. My God. Mighty God, talk up pure things. Hey, rock my soul. Share the video, this morning. Share the video to some prophets this morning. Share the video to some evangelists this morning, because they need to hear this. This one is a bombshell. God Almighty dropped the bombshell this morning. With it, because when God talk up, God give the scripture same time. Mighty God, all of us were saying we don't know what God looks like. A lot of us saying God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. When you ask what color is God's skin, him no have no color, because my spirit joke can make this morning. God get serious, gotta talk up this morning. So all the black race run out and run come. In a master God kingdom, you know, Lord God Almighty, all of them lying trickery get turned over this morning. Lolly. I know God was up to something, you know. You see, from God sent me out Friday night to come play all different kind of music. God Almighty knew the persecution was gonna come, so God give me everything to match up who him is now. So you don't have to wonder who is God, where God come from, who God is. God talk up now. And the Almighty God dwell amongst us as we speak. Don't believe that him in the sky coming down. The Almighty God dwell amongst us. Turn your Bibles to Job 30 and verse 30. Everybody get your Bible. Job 30 and verse 30. We're going to get into the nitty-gritty of it. It is approximately 15 minutes to the hour of 9. Make we just get busy. Let us just get busy and speak what the Lord has told me to speak to the black nation. Job 30 and verse 30. Come on now, just text God a talk up. I said, text on the line, God, a talk up. I said, ignorant for some liar people where really come deceive so many people across the globe. Job chapter 30 and verse 30. Are you there? If you are there, just text, yes, I am ready to do the word. I am ready to speak the word. Come on, my divine family. We are about to speak. I'm about to speak what God told me to come and tell the black nation. Share the videos to all the black people across the globe, to your friends, your family, people who you don't even know. Turn the Bible to Job chapter 30 and verse 30. And the reason why we have to go down in Job, because Job is the man who went through great tribulation. Job is the man who went through great tribulation. And because the black nation went through great tribulation, we will kick it off with Job 30 and verse 30. Listen what the Almighty God said to tell you. My God! Are at Job 30 and verse 30. I am ready. Are we going about three people? We want at least six people that is at Job 30 and verse 30. So Ellie Thompson says she's ready. Margaret Joseph says she's ready. Ophelia Watt says she's ready. Sylvester Bell says ready. Say I'm ready. Listen what God said to tell all of you as people of black nation. My skin is black. Job chapter 30 and verse 30. God is speaking now. My skin is black upon me, and my bones are burnt with heat. What did the Messiah say to tell the nation? Job chapter 30 and verse 30. He said to tell all the black nation that always pray and say God is a spirit, and they that worship him, worship him in spirit and in truth. And when you ask them what color is the skin of God, them say me no know. Well, the Almighty God is revealing himself to you today. Job chapter 30 and verse 30, God is telling you and I, my skin is black. Upon me, and my bones are burnt with heat. So the Almighty God is revealing Job 30 and verse 30 to tell all of you, black, white, Chinese, Indian, my skin is black. Our God that we pray to, he is a black man. Black people, you need to start value yourself as goddesses and the little baby gods that God made. Don't be afraid to say if you're a woman, you're a goddess. If God's skin is black and he have created you in his own image, you are a goddess. And if you're a male, you are the young god of God. The baby god. This message is going to be so strong and powerful, you're going to wonder. Don't let them trick you as if you are nobody. Once you are a female, I am telling you today, the Holy Spirit said to let all of you women know, start to wear your gowns and your robe, because you are goddesses. God has created you in his own image and likeness. You are king and queens. Job 30 and verse 30 is telling you, I am black, says God. That's number one. Turn your Bibles with me to the Song of Solomon 1 and verse 5. Turn your Bibles now to Songs of Solomon 1 and verse 5. Share, we need 14 more share. Come on, people, share up the line. Share the line up. Diana Francis, good morning to you. Adina Thomas, good morning. Carmen Wallin, good morning. Share up the line 10 times each. We only have 36 share. Hurry up. Diana Francis, share the videos 10 times. Glory, hallelujah. Songs of Solomon. 1 and verse 5. Share the videos. Song of Solomon 1 and verse 5, because God Almighty is getting very technical and very personal. Because a lot of people want to style the Almighty God. It won't work. The stylings won't work. The Almighty God know him put radical soldier upon battlefield where come talk up. And I want black people to start, get yourself in line, put yourself together, stop dressing like prostitutes, stop becoming male prostitute and female prostitute. You are a goddess. You are some little baby gods that God has created. Turn your Bible to Songs of Solomon, 1 of verse 5, because God talking up this morning. Please write down these scriptures as I give it them to you. So when you're talking, you have scriptures to back you up. So I must first reveal what Solomon, the name Solomon meant. Because what these guys do is to remix and rewrite. Song of Solomon meant the song of a solo man. The song of a solo man. So what you're going to do, you're going to write song. Then you're going to write S-O-L-O, solo. Then you're going to put a little stroke between it and you're going to write man. They have wrote M-O-N. It is not M-O-N. I'm going to give you the definition. The Almighty God said to tell all of the world, it is not M-O-N. It is M-A-N. But because the Europeans speak mon, Songs of Solomon, they are European, so they write mon, M-O-N. It is not M-O-N. It is M-A-N. This is the real revelation of who God the Messiah is. He is the Messiah. So it is song. It is a song. And solo means one person, solo man. A solo. It's song You know, in we say, okay, this person is going to give an item of a solo. A solo means one song. A solo man. M-A-N. So it's not Song of Solomon. It is supposed to be sung from Solomon. Listen now. I am black and comely. O ye daughters of Jerusalem, as the tents of Kedah, as the curtains of Solomon. Are you comprehending what I am saying? Let me read it again. Songs of Solomon 1 and verse 5 says, I am black and comely, O ye daughters of Jerusalem, as the tents of Kedah, as the curtains of Solomon. So back into those days, both God Almighty and his disciples were black people. Solomon was a black man. The Almighty Yahweh was a black man. He is known as the Messiah. He is a black man. Song of Solomon. Solomon was a black man. And the Almighty God definitely letting you know, I am black, but I am comely. I am black. I am black, but I am comely. I am very welcoming. I am very loving. I am black. I'm comely. Very welcoming. I am loving person. I don't mean evil. I don't mean harm. I am loving person, says God. Black, but comely. So I am here to let some people know you have a lot of explanation to do. All you Europeans who transform the Bible into something different to trick the black people as if they're nobody, they're no good. Our God is a black man. You also lock up into your homes worshiping black gods and goddesses. You cannot survive without the black race. You cannot run a business without a black man inside of it, because you know the truth that the God that we all serve, he is a black man. So if you recognize all the businesses across the globe that other races run, they must have a black man or woman inside that business to run it, because they knew you are goddesses and gods. So they can't run a business and be successful without the black man or woman. So right here, Song of Solomon letting you know, I am black, but comely. I'm sorry, oh, beg your pardon. So as of this day, you will not enslave us no more. As of this day, we will not take your crap no more. As of this day, we won't take your juke no more, because the God that we serve is a black man. So because he is a black man, he will understand our black attitude. He will understand our black reasoning. He will understand. And I know when I pray and I says, God, they come again, I know he will step in and do what he's supposed to do to make your ship sink. My father is a black man. People that are Christians, people that are Rastafarians, all of them, I want you to know, which most Rastas already know, the Almighty God is a black man. So I am talking to the body of Christ, the churches around the globe. The Almighty God that you pray to is a black man. Take the white image out of your buildings. Take the white images off of your almanac. Take the white image out of your churches, says the Messiah. Churches, take it out of your buildings, take it out of your house. God Almighty is not a white man. God said, I am black but comely, into Solomon chapter 1 and verse 5. Glory, Job 30 verse 30. God deliberately telling us, I am black. Take them white, blue eye out of your churches. Take them out of your houses. My father is a black man. He said to come and tell the nation, I am black. I dwell among you on a daily basis. You can't even see me because you did not expect your God to be a black man. Glory, hallelujah. Turn your Bibles to Jeremiah 14 and verse 2. Turn your Bibles with me now to Jeremiah 14 and verse 2, because the Almighty God is getting very technical. Drum roll. I said, when the fire them a drop, me have to get strictly drum roll. Me can't do the fire them, I have to do them on that drum roll. We have to get the heavy drum beat. Jeremiah 14 and verse 2 now. Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish. They are black unto the ground, and the cry of Jerusalem is gone up. Write it down. Jeremiah 14 and verse 2. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwells therein. Jeremiah 14 and verse 2. Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish. They are black unto the ground, and the cry of Jerusalem is gone up. We came from dust, and we will go back to dust, because man of dust. My people, this is what they don't want you to know. They don't want you to identify yourself and who you serve, dear God. Our God is a black man, a powerful and great man. He is not a ghost, and the Almighty God is not a dopey. He is real. Check the levels. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit loves music. And he also honors musicians. What they teach you, if the music now called Jesus' name, it is not music. That is a lie from the pit of hell. We came from the dust. We came from the ground, and we will go back to the ground. So if you recognize the devil was a main man in heaven singing on the choir in heaven. So he knows the hearts of God. Satan was a chief musician who knows the heart of the Almighty God. He knows that the Almighty God loves musician. So Satan, after God cast him out of heaven, he came on earth, dominate the earth, and he makes sure take residence in the music industry, because he know that the Almighty God himself loves music, and he loves the angels to sing music to him all the time. The Almighty God loves musicians. He speak about the chief musician in his Bible. If you notice musicians right across the world, whether they sing gospel or they sing secular music, the musician age very gracefully. Just take a look at some musicians. When you hear their age, you cannot believe how old they are, and they age so gracefully. You cannot believe they are that old and looking so young. Whether they sing gospel or they sing secular, there is something about the chief musician, the players and the singers of instruments. The Almighty God loves the musician. God gave them youthfulness like an eagle. So the devil know that. That is why he makes sure enter the music industry to manipulate the musicians. Notice what the devil does. He enter the music industry, manipulate the musicians, and after they are rising to power, especially the black musician. Just check what the devil do. The devil always sacrifice the black musician, because Satan himself know that God Almighty was a black man. So the devil sit into the music industry to watch the next one that is rising and sacrifice the black men and women into the music industry, because the devil himself knew that God was a black man. So right now it is spiritual warfare upon our black nation. So the Almighty God is revealing himself. The Almighty God revealing himself. And if you realize, he revealed himself to a chief musician, because I am a musician. He had was to reveal himself to someone who into the music industry, to let the world know, I am black. God said, I am black. And he loved the chief musician. Whether you sing gospel or you sing secular, we are all God's children. The devil went into the music industry and transformed the people to sing nonsense, to sing about guns, to sing about nudity, to sing about craziness. Is the devil orchestrate all of that? Because if you allow these artists to sing that is coming from their soul, they would never sing such nonsense. The devil formate himself as agent of light and have these musicians singing nonsense. The Almighty God is still speaking of who he really is. Turn your Bibles with me to Genesis chapter 2 and verse 7. Turn your Bibles with me to Genesis chapter 2 and verse 7. And he also revealed who Genesis was. Genesis 2 and verse 7. I'm going to break down the name Genesis. Her name is Jenny. G-E-N, Jenny. And back into those days, they would refer her as sis. Jenny, come here, sis. The Europeans know what they did. Genesis, her name is Jen. Jenny. And they refer her as sis, because if you recognize how the Rasta man speak, heal sister, heal my brethren. Listen how the church speak. It's my church sister. What is the shortening of sister? Sis. So Jenny sees, her name is Jenny. So Jenny speaks. Genesis 2 and verse 7. And the Lord God formed man of the dust. He formed mankind of the dust on the ground and breathed into his nostril the breath of life. And mankind became a living soul. So this is what Jenny wrote. Jenny is giving us the history, how God has created man. She's the storyteller. She's the one who telling us as the world who come, how the Almighty God has formed mankind. When you write Genesis, you're going to write G-E-N-E. Then you're going to put a little stroke in between and write S-I-S and bracket that. Her name is Jenny. Jenny. She's our sister. The European didn't want us to figure it out. But the Almighty Yahweh figuring it out. And let me come to teach you today. So today you are into Jerusalem. Jerusalem. Schoolroom. Jerusalem. Schoolroom. So you're going to write on the line Jenny. And you're going to bracket S-I-S, sis. She's our sister. Should have been our older sister because she were here long before us. So this is what she wrote. And the Lord formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed unto him in his nostril the breath of life. And man became a living soul. G. Forbes, good morning, my dear. Forrest Humble, good morning. Please text on the line Jen, Jenny, G-E-N-E, and you bracket the word S. Has how I get it? I am giving it to you. This is the revelation coming from the Messiah himself. So he both give me the scriptures, give me the definition, tell me where they messed up, where did they go wrong. So this lady that spoke, her name is Jenny. Her name is Jenny. Her name doesn't spell with a J. Her name spell with a G. G-E-N-E. And the S-I-S represents sister. So as of this day, you know that Jenny is Jenny. She's our sister. She spoke about how the Almighty God created mankind as history. But the European tried to change it up, to trick us, to keep us in the dark. They want us to always stay into the dark. We don't know the truth, but the truth is formating itself to us directly. So her name is Jenny. Sis. You know, Rastaman say, hey sis, come here. Your church brother say, sis, just a minute. Her name is Jenny. She's our little sister. In Christ, she's our sister. Glory, hallelujah. So she let us know that God has created us from the dust. Blow into our nostril and man became a living soul. Glory, hallelujah. So therefore we came from the dust. God has formed us from the earth, the ground. The same ground that we walk on. The same ground that we spit on. The same ground that we treat bad. The Almighty God formed us from the ground. So the big question is, where does God really dwell? That's the big question I know everybody's going to ask us. Where does God really dwell? He dwells everywhere. The Almighty God dwells everywhere. But the Almighty God takes great pleasure manifesting himself underneath the earth coming up. So if you realize, the European told us, when you die, you go to hell. And when you ask them, where is hell? They told you, hell is under the earth. Hell is not under the earth. Hell is on earth. Let me show you how these Europeans are very evil. They teach us a doctrine and tell us, when you die, you go to hell, and when you go to hell, you go on burning hell under the earth. Who created the earth? God Almighty. How did God create us? He created us from the earth. The Almighty God created us from the earth. He dwells under the earth also to make your crop grow up. Notice when you plant anything in the earth, it grows up beautiful, fresh, and green. When you disrespect the Almighty God, He Himself erupts. And you know how funny it is, when you get an earthquake, God is walking on the earth. This is another thing you need to know. When you get an earthquake anywhere you are, God enters the earth and start walking. So when Him start walk on the earth and tread the earth start bust up. When Him stand up and Him kimbo and stays up, the earth does not open up. So He walks the earth with His rod. So at each time He step, the earth quakes. Your houses go down. He always have His rod and His sword in His hand. When He swing His sword, when the Almighty God swing His sword, your house is going down. Don't disrespect the earth that you walk on. Start learn how to respect the ground that you walk on. The Almighty God talking today. So the Almighty God takes great pleasure under the earth. The earth that we walk upon, we must respect the ground. God dwells there too. He dwells in the universe too. He dwells all around also. He even walked the earth among us. When He walks the earth, you get a whole lot of wind passing through because the Almighty God is passing through the earth. The Almighty God passing through the earth, so you recognize that you were tricked, you were schemed, and you were conned. It is a very sad situation to recognize that you were tricked, you were schemed, and you were conned. I want you to text on the line, God a taco. Text on the line, God a taco. If you recognize, He placed diamonds underneath the earth for you and I. The Almighty Yahweh places diamonds underneath the earth for you and I to do gold mine and diamond mine and oil mine for us to stay wealthy and live happily. Europeans, you know, I think we need to give you an earthquake today. Europeans, I think we need to give you an earthquake today. My daddy decided to give you a very terrible jerk today. You are so wicked. Europeans, you are so wicked. My father is black. And if my father is a god, I am a goddess. So I can speak out of my mouth and tell my father how to deal with you. And once I tell my father how to deal with you, he will jerk your territory. I am speaking with pride this morning. I am speaking with authority this morning. I say me hyping a God this morning. Try and test me and you see what my God do to you. You are evil, oh. Very evil. My Father, I need for you to pass through this earth. One more time. Pass through Europe, where our slave masters are, that bring spiritual warfare to us, that rob all the things that you gave to us under the earth, like the diamonds and the golds and the rubies and the pearl and the oil. Mighty God, show them a sign, oh. My Father, jerk their world, I beg. A lot of my brothers and sisters, oh God Almighty, they didn't know, they don't understand. They just come up and raise and hear about this blue-eyed man that they should have prayed to. Father, I thank you so much for this kind of revelation, my Father. But Lord, I stand in the gap for my black brothers and sisters. Father, go through the earth, oh God Almighty. Go down in Europe, oh Daddy, and jerk their territory. Walk with authority on the ground and show them who you are as the Messiah. My Father, a jerk their territory right now. I decree and I declare, my Father, you are the Messiah. My black brothers and sisters, oh God Almighty, suffer the hands of the wicked. Day in and day out, oh God Almighty, they cry. Everything that they do, they disturb them, oh God. If they do music, oh God Almighty, to make their daily bread, they sacrifice them, Father. You gave us diamonds and gold to lift off and oil, oh God. They came and they raid the bomb and steal it. Mighty God of Daniel, jerk their world and let their world be miserable, I pray. Let them cannot sleep, the ones who steal and rob us, I pray, God. They have done evil to our people. They have done evil to us. And then put us to become beggars. Put us to become beggars and begging for charity to feed each other. When they know that they are stealing, they have robbed everything that you have placed under the earth for us. And gave us false doctrine to worship. Baal, O God Almighty, shift the atmosphere, I pray. Lord, draw forth your sword. I pray in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, draw your sword, my Father. Defend your people, my Father. Mighty God, you have taught us how to dress ladylike and gentlemanlike, oh God Almighty, and they teach our people how to go naked. You have created Adam and Eve in the garden, oh God Almighty, and they're creating Adam and Steve. Oh God Almighty, draw your sword. Draw your sword, oh God Almighty, and walk the earth, oh God. And defend us, I pray. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, Lord. I thank you for the revelation. You are so awesome, my Father. I thank you for the revelation. So my people don't have to be crying and wondering, what do you look like? They don't have to be imagining that you are a spirit, because you are not a ghost. You are a living man. Father, I thank you for such revelation. Father, you are so awesome. People who really loves the Lord God Almighty. But because you raised as a child, grow up, come here about one person, and he is a spirit, you can't see him. You only can feel him. Mighty God, I thank you for the people that are on the line, that they can hear who you really are. What your complexion is like, and you're still treading the earth today. Magically, they can't see you, but we can see your handiworks. I want to speak to Europe today. And I must warn you for the last morning. I must warn you, Europe, for the last time, because if you don't take this warning serious, you will see what God do to you. All the artifacts that you have stolen from Africa, bring them back. All the countries that you have tied up underneath your slave trade, desist. Get these people out of the monarch. And I am speaking this with no apology, because my Father gave me all authority to talk. As a strong black woman, God has created me, and my God is a black man. And if God is God, I know I am a goddess, says God. Bring back everything that you have stolen, because I am here to tell you this morning, the cookie is crumbling. The time has come. The warnings has to be done. For the rightful Messiah and the rightful King of Kings and Lord of Lords to take back his throne. So all those fake thrones that you have sitting on with the wealth of the black man, you need to return it, because if you don't return it, my Father will get inside of your body and wreck that life out. As it is written, thus said my Father, Yahweh, the truth and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me, says God. The time has come when you must return all the stolen things that you have stolen from the great black men and women of society. You have stolen our gold and diamond and pearls and ruby, and also stole the land. Bring it back. forgetting to bring it back. Heko sarabaka. As it is written, so shall it be done, says my Father, Yahweh. Time has come. The earth will shake and your world will crumble because God had shot to man. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Messiah has given you. Only 52 days. You will see how throne go down. You will see how throne go down. Some trust in chariots and some in horses. But we will continually to trust in the Messiah, the higher, higher. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the conquering lion from the tribe of Judah, the breath that is into your bodies will be taken out, says the Messiah. Hail! Europe, the time has come. The game is over. Think you're in heaven? but you live in a hell. You think you're in heaven, but you live in a hell. Time alone, time will tell. You think you're in heaven, but you live in a hell. You go around, you search the planet Earth, and everywhere you find oil, you capture it, you steal it, you use badness to take it away from my tribe and nation, says the Messiah. Let me remind you. Songs of Solomon 1 and verse 5. I am black, but comely. O ye daughters of Zion, as the tents of Kedar, and as the curtains of Solomon. God Almighty is a black man. Job 30 verse 30 says, my skin is black upon me, and my bones are burnt with heat. Jenny, sis, 2 verse 7 says, the Lord God formed mankind out of dust, out of the ground, breathed unto in their nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. You see that Messiah that breathed. You see that Messiah that breathed through the nostril of humans and let them become living soul. 52 days we are giving Europe. Every solitary coin, crowns, diamonds, pearl, and gold that you have stolen, bring it back. If you don't, you will see how much your life leaving your body slowly, because my Father says he will slowly take you off his planet. Alabokosa, Rebeke Satarabakosa Taya, Rebo Soya. As it is written, thus saith the Lord thy God, the Messiah. He won't take you out fast. He won't take you out very fast. My Father said he will take you out slowly. So you will feel pain before you go home. You will sick. You will sick before you go. You will sick before you go. Feel the pain before you go. But all the wickedness that you brought to mankind, and to the black race of Africa and Africa descendants, you will pay for it on your sickbed, says the Messiah. Return them now, says the Almighty God. The game is over. All the destruction that you placed on them to make them suffer, during their lives. You will pay for it on your sick bed, says the Almighty God. Not just you alone, your fourth and fifth and sixth and seventh and eighth and nine and tenth generation will pay for it, says the Messiah. As it is written, so shall it be, says the Almighty Yahweh. Hear us. Come forth. Get into their homes and destroy them. Come forth. Get into their homes in Europe. Lay them to sick. And slowly destroy them. They are evil. Hero! Get into their home. Their sick bed, punish them before they die. So Europe, you have tricked them, you swear you win. The goddess is here. The Almighty God created us like himself. So if he is God, he have created us as the goddesses. So we come forth with the strength of the Messiah to command you. To command you, bring them back. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. The world and they that dwells therein. Mankind was formed from the earth. The Almighty God is a black man. He's not a ghost. And he's no spirit. He's a living man. And Europe, you know that. Europe, you know God is a black man. Europe, you knew God is a black man. You tricked them. You blindfold them. And you gave them your own nonsense to worship. I am here to let you know you will pay for it. Not just you alone. Up to your 10th generation and beyond. Says the Messiah, the Ayah. As it is written, so shall it be now, says the Messiah. My final remarks is, judge not, else ye be judged. Judge not. No, God. Almighty for yourselves. This Bible that we have, it is a guidebook from the Almighty, the Messiah. The Word, the Bible, is the guide from the Messiah, and you remix even the Bible. It is not 10 commandments, it is 42 commandments. You have hidden 32 of them. You only give 10 commandments, and it is 42. You have hidden all the commandments and only give them 10. And the 10 that you have given them, they fail everyone. Mankind, I am here to tell you today, the guidebook is your Bible. Take time to read, search, and know God for yourself. The Almighty God is a living man, and he is a black man. Christ, in his kingly character. So I am here to tell all those fakers. I am here to tell all them fakers that fake their way through, make movies presenting themselves on throne like they are the originals. You will soon find out who is the original, because you are pulling me today to ask the Messiah to send forth and jerk the earth somewhere in Europe. My Father, my Messiah, come forth, jerk somewhere in Europe. Jerk some throne in Europe and show them that you are the Messiah. As it is written, so shall it be done. So I want the people to know, stop spitting on the ground. Stop spitting on the ground. Stop destroying the ground that you walk on. Because as Jenny, our bigger sister, told us, the Lord God formed man. Formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into the nostrils the breath of life, and mankind become living soul. And always remember, black people, don't feel guilty of nothing. Let me tell you who are the sinners. Because all the time they tell you, come to the altar, because you are sinners. I am going to tell you who are the sinners today. It is approximately 10 minutes to the hour of 10. We want to close. But let us just tell you who are the sinners today. The sinners. Or your slave masters who have placed your foreparents on slave ship and abused them. The sinners are the ones who invade other people's territory and steal their lands, their golds, their diamonds, their pearls. They are the sinners. The sinners are the ones who are into the organization of slave trade. Human trafficking. Those are the sinners. So I am here to tell my black brothers and sisters, don't feel guilty of yourself if you have sex, a woman having sex with a man, or a man having sex with a woman, that's natural. The sinners are the ones who invade your territory and steal your land, your gold, your diamond, your oil. Those are the sinners. This is my few words. For Christ's sake, I pray. Amen. Almighty Father, we thank you for the word. We thank you for the message. We thank you for the boldness. We thank you for the instructions. I hope that the people that joined the line today learned something, oh Father. Into Jerusalem schoolroom, I pray. Cover us as we go our separate ways, I pray. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Mother, in the name of the Mother of creation. Peace, rest, remain, abide with us now, even forevermore, I humble pray. Amen. Have a blessed and productive day today, my people. Shalom. The Holy Spirit given me something to tell you. I want the people of God, the pastors and the evangelists, and all of you to know this. I heard all of you singing about the rapture. Everyone is waiting for the rapture. I will tell you today, the rapture is here. Thus saith the Lord thy God, because the rapture was created by the slave masters. The rapture that they are speaking about, that people will disappear and you can't find them, the rapture is here. What is the rapture, though? The Messiah told me to tell you. The rapture is rape and torture. The rapture is the rape and torture and kidnapping. That is the rapture. So I want the body of Christ to know the rapture is going on right now. It is called the rape and torture. Write it on the line. Get your notebooks and write it. Write it on the line. Rapture. It is the rape and the torture of the children and the people. So as we speak, the rapture is going on for a good time now. It is going on now. Kidnapping of the young girls for slave trade, that is the rapture. You doubt me? Time will tell. Have a blessed and productive day today. I gave you that one for free. Standing on the road, There's gonna be another death at the royal home, says the Messiah. Sooner than you think. The lane of rest can be prevented in the royal home if they do what I say. The death can be prevented if you do what I say. You will have to take the land of Jamaica out of the monarch, says the oracle. Take the land of Jamaica out of the monarch, says the oracle. You see, the oracle lives in Jamaica. And if the Messiah says Jamaica needs to be freed because my oracle is there. If you want a couple more years to live, run and tell Jamaican government you need to exit Jamaica out of the monarch and free up all the lands that was captured. As it is written, thus said the Messiah, if you want a couple more years to your life, if you don't, the world will hear, says God. I give life, and I also take it away. Yamusa Yamaha, Libriusa Yamahe. Nabusa yama hasu yama. Libra kusaya Rebeka usaya. Nea isa yama osa. Labri iso yama esa yama osa yama e. Na lebra kosa yama isa yama e. Na yusa yama o. No retreat, no surrender. Well, God give life. And he take it away. God gives life. And he takes it away. You don't surrender, you don't retreat. Well, that's the final hymn he has given. He gives life. And he takes it away. Labroyo sayama, ne yasiyama.
Nebu usa yalaba. Lebro so yama e. Ayayo, ayayo. The same Asian spirit that you're working with into your territory. He is a black man. We will use him to fight against you. You think we don't know who you are praying over? You are praying over one of our ancestors. And you swear, God, you got the power. Well, we will use him to fight you. The Almighty give life and he take it away. I spoke about the crown to return the crown to Ethiopia. And these diamonds that you have stolen. You let it went through one ear and flick back through the other ear. You don't respond. So you will have your first generation, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth generation and beyond will suffer the consequences now, says the Messiah.